Yes. There's the whole
1894,
back.
1889, 1894, something like this. So it's late 1900s.
Yeah. Always this era, right? Have you ever heard that there's this term for the 19th century that's called the long 19th century?
No, really?
You have, oh, it's like this term where they explain away why so many things happened in the 19th century. It almost sounds like they're saying that the 19th century was actually stretched.
Yeah, it could have been because this idea of the contained environment that was brought up in the WestWorld series. Have you seen him on
Yeah, I've
HBO?
seen 4 episodes of it, then I lost interest.
Yeah, it doesn't bring much information in the first 5, 6 episodes, and then it just envelops, 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 and then it becomes interesting. So the idea
Okay.
of all this stuff is also in the middle or late 19th century. So. And
Yeah,
it's
so much I saw, yes.
yeah, and so we have a bunch of people that are actually androids, and they act similar and being programmed by somebody who is controlling them in favor of all those guests who paying them money. So at certain point, those guests and the residents start fighting and severely that androids make it some type of revolution. They capture everybody, kill everybody, and stuff like this. So it's like a whole bunch of mess. And it sounds like actually how things could be working here. So I mean, there's a bunch of ideas that this environment brings me, and this old Wild West. This is 19th century, the final frontier, as they call it in American history, when the people were moving to the West in large numbers, just capturing the land that was left by the Indians that were pressed in the small reservations and totally cut out of supplies on all these buffaloes and all huge, huge stockpiles of buffalo skulls and stuff like this. Have you? So I've been in this environment, and I felt it by myself because I was living there in Wyoming, and that was pretty interesting for me. And I would like to come back and check it out one more time. So because all this Westworld, brought me so many ideas of how these actually things could be made in this reset, because they also make
That's
resets
interesting.
in this Westworld. They make reset, they make update, and those androids starting all over again, forgetting who they were in the previous, previous versions, and
Oh, yeah,
yeah.
that's very interesting. Even if it's not, one-to-one reality, maybe there is a lot of truth in that and the way it's done, and a lot of the details can perhaps lead you to new questions and new findings. So I have found a lot of, let's say, personal discoveries from, you know, and synchronicities from watching a lot of movies, and I always like to have a, you know, a decoding mind. You can't not have it at this point, right? You watch a movie and you cannot, you know, stop yourself from trying to think about it in all sorts of different ways. You can't just lay back and enjoy the movie as you used to. It's impossible.
Yeah. I'm sure. Yeah. It is.
Yeah, this is a French book, which, of course, masonry. And it's an architecture book, but this book is really, really crazy. It shows something I've never seen before. It shows some sort of pillar work that is, yeah, I've never seen such pillar work before, like on these angles, and look at these things that are connecting them. It doesn't seem to be a support thing. It seems rather to be, dare I say, pneumatic tech, like air running in here, steam perhaps. And these clocks, why would you have two? Could they be meters? But they look like clocks, but why have two though? Seems a little bit over the top. And this book is mind-blowing, you'll see why. This is inside of a church. And all of this, it's unexplained in the book. It's just an architecture book. But to me, this looks like technology. But look how it's, you know, they have these openings in the ceiling. And, this looks nearly Egyptian, like you would have on the Egyptian pillars. They look like flowers, some of them. And am I not to suppose something is running in here? Either water or air?
Very interesting.
Because do you remember the ventilation systems I've shown you also, where you had these knobs on the ceiling and they would detail like a ventilation machine, and they would look like these things that come down from the roofs? It's a long time ago, but
I think it's
maybe
just
you
know, we see this one in the back. It's fully, you know, all attached and everything.
Yeah.
Looks fulfilled. And this one before is just, you know, the half cut, the same one that is in the back. So this
what do you think this is, though?
Some connections. I don't know. Probably the wires or something. Some cables. I don't know.
But it's safe to... I have never seen anything like this before. I've looked through a lot of books, also architecture books. This is a one-of-a-kind thing.
It's like, you know, a string or something, but I doubt it can hold this construction.
I don't think it's to do with anything constructional, no. Yeah, as you say.
So
I don't think it holds
it up. If it's not strings, then it's just some type of cables that can hold...
These looks like when you have like a hotel, and outside of the hotel you have all the flags, and then they have these things going, sticking out, like horizontally into the street. And I've seen them on all photos. These, and they don't have anything on them. It's just like this, and people have been asking questions as to what they may be. Just like a iron pole sticking out horizontally. Especially in front of hotels and luxury buildings and such, with flags. Maybe embassies also. They seem to be some sort of part of the construction here. So these on the street were also part of some sort of thing like this. I don't know.
Why not?
Because, yeah, they definitely look exactly the same. But... But I wanted to show you some more of this book. There's some French text, but it doesn't really address some of the questions I would have as to the drawings. This is not that interesting. But here you have some more of what we saw just before.
Mm-hmm.
Some of this church tech, as I call it. And here's some of the principles. Like, this reminds me of the knee, like the
mm-hmm.
knee socket.
Mm-hmm.
So that's very interesting, and also here you can see like these large pillars. Like, what would they be used for? Why do they need them to have them on an angle here? And
is anything like this kept alive?
No, I've never seen anything like this before in like real life either. You see up here, they have these knobs, kind of low resolution, but they have like these ventilation knobs, I
It's
would think.
all looks like, you know, some sacred geometry that they were researching back in the days, you know, because all this, you know, angles, and this is just sacred fractal geometry, nothing else.
You think also with the pillars?
I think that this is all the whole construction works on some different principles of this fractal or sacred geometry.
Oh yeah,
All
right.
this geometry is dependent on all those, you know, the network of Hartmann that is, you know, all around the world, and we have this, you know, intersection of the network that could be, you know, easily measured, and each and there's negative and positive ones and all this intersection, and they knew all this sacred geometry, and they knew how to attach those buildings into those places of this intersection of this energy, you know, coming out of the ground actually. So,
Yeah, that's also
and this is
what
how
we're
it was
finding.
implemented. We find it crazy to make this type of, you know, construction for nothing, for just, you know, simply architectural craziness. But it's actually a device, a working device that is integrated into the landscape that was already known for some certain properties, physical properties.
What do you think this is, Philipp? This is inside a church also.
It
You
looks
have
like
an
it's like
organ.
a, yeah, organ, some sound device, resonator.
Right, but I wanted to point out, like, this really reminds me of something I've seen before. It reminds me of this.
Yeah.
The electromagnetic motor from EG in Berlin. Yeah. Or AEG, of course, sorry. This is from the 1890s. So this really, really much reminds me of it. And that would be like an electromagnetic motor. And to be placed on the organ also makes me think that, you know, how sound creates a magnetic field? Maybe
Yeah,
that's the connection. Sound is really magnetic in like. It's subtle, but
Tesla
yeah.
had a patent in Russia and in USA about this, you know, resonating energy that could be, you know, transferred on distances. So,
Right.
organ is a great resonation device, right? So, why might as well, you know, attach something like this, like you showed.
Yeah. And then there's also something comparable. They call these sulfur mines, abandoned sulfur mines on White Island, I think it's called, in New Zealand. Yeah. So you can ponder if that's the case. I don't really think so, but I don't really know. So I haven't looked too much into it, but it's just comparable with these rings. Some also see Stargate because of a ring, but I would think
Yeah, well,
no, it's more probable it's some sort of electromagnetic device.
have you seen anyone from any star? So
No.
probably no Stargate either, you know.
Nope.
Just, it's all here, guys. Nobody goes anywhere.
Have you ever seen, like, in Moscow, in the ceiling of some of the very large buildings, these holes? Because I've seen those, like, today they would but just be like holes up here, and maybe they would be like bricked over or painted over. But on this picture, it looks very much like they were like some sort of fitting for the oil lamps or some other lamp. So I'm just trying to go back through this art and see like how some of these church buildings looked like in the past, and there's a lot of differences as to how they did things back then and how they do them right now. And I find that interesting. Also, I've never seen a fireplace like this one.
Yeah, it looks like a, you know, how do you call it? Infrared heater system.
Yeah, like I haven't followed too much of the research on stolenhistory.org, but they had a topic about these being radium repeaters. And that had a lot of promising information to it. There was a lot of old art showing that there was a time, at least I think 100, maybe 150 years ago, where people were obsessed with radium and what it could do in all sorts of things, and radium-infused water and radium heaters and radium, everything. And then suddenly some guy discovered that it was radioactive and not healthy, and then it all stopped, which is also like it just reminds me of the Zeppelin story, right, where they have this whole era of Zeppelins. It's a short era, and then one incident with flammable gas, and then nope, let's shut it all down, boys, across all countries. Just makes no sense.
Scripted events.
Scripted reality, yeah. This one I've shown before, like the Vanderbilt mansion. Just very, like, it's a fireplace and an organ in one. And these would be some of the ventilation knobs, or what looked like in the book, what showed to be ventilation knobs. I'm not exactly sure, but the ventilation systems of the old days definitely had these things coming from the roof, and they were, yeah, designed like this. So, maybe. This is an old stamp. It was like an illumination book, you know, the word illuminations, and you search for that word, and on this stamp it referenced something to do with electrostatics. And if you see a lot of the columns and illumination picks, they have like these lighting things going mm-hmm. around them, like a coil.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this is this, some of it. And they're calling this electrostatic. And you can also see here, this is the fireworks. So they're calling a lot of this electrostatic. So I just wanted to show people, like, the illumination word yielded this, electrostatic, when I search for it. And so I wonder, a lot of this indoor illumination, like on the side of the, on the walls, right? Like, this definitely would, I don't think those would be candles. And those necessarily, like, the lower candles are burning the upper candles and such. There's all sorts of questions. And these definitely are incandescent or some sort of other technology, electrical. It's not like we think.
It's just a nonsense. You cannot, you know, illuminate the whole palace or something like this in thousands and thousands and thousands of square meters of, you know, different rooms, ballrooms, hallways. You just cannot, you know, handle all this stuff with candles. It's easily performed with electricity, but you cannot.
Yeah.
Nobody showed me any picture or photograph.
But see here, Philip.
With candles.
Like, you see these flower lights? You see these? And they have, like, these perhaps metal fittings. Now, take a closer look at the spire. You see these? Don't they look like the same?
Perhaps.
Just a question, yes, but they definitely, to me, look like the same. And when I go further with this technology, look at this lighting technology. It has connected with metal, and they have these bridges here, and they look like you could stick small little bulbs here, and they would light up, and be transferred by the metal. And on this bridge, you have something very similar, like a bridge of metal.
Mm-hmm.
And here in Italy, you have it with bulbs, bridge of metal, and with bulbs here ready to be lit up. So I'm making all these sorts of connections, like also this here, metal, bulbs, lit up. As we've seen many times with Moscow, these light up. So, yeah. This is a bit more under the loop, I think. Like, I'm really trying to get to the bottom of what this technology was and how they did it. And, yeah, I'm not certain, of course. But I think it has to do with electrostatics, at least some of it.